So dear students, in our last lecture we have seen the tree traversal in detail, and in this lecture we will see what is the concept of AVL tree. Actually, AVL tree is the balanced tree in which the balancing of nodes has been always there. AVL tree was invented by Edelson, Welensky and Landis, and because of that it is called as the AVL tree. So now we can see over here that if the input is in non-increasing manner, then the tree looks like this. It is starting from 10, then 14, 19, 35 and 42. And if it is in non-decreasing manner, then it's coming like 10, 14, 19, 35 and 42. So it is observed that the binary search tree's worst case performance is closest to the linear search algorithm, that is O of N. But in real time data, we cannot predict the data pattern as well as their frequency, because now in this, when we are learning the algorithms, we know the data pattern and what is the exact data in the particular example. But whenever the real-time data occurs, at that time we cannot predict the data pattern and their frequencies, because whenever we are dealing with real-time data, generally it is in large manner. So it is necessary, the need is there, the necessity is there to balance the existing binary search tree, and for that the AVL tree is very useful. So the inventor of AVL trees are Edelson, Welensky and Landis, and that's why it is called as AVL tree. It is the tree which is height balancing binary search tree. As I already said, the height is balanced in this particular tree. So AVL tree checks the height of left subtree and right subtree. It checks whether left subtree is having more height or right subtree is having more height, and according to that, whatever difference is there, finding out the difference by using the balance factor, the tree gets balanced. So whenever the AVL tree checks the height of left subtree and right subtree, and it assures that the difference is not more than 1. The difference between the height is nothing but the balance factor. So balance factor plays the important role in the AVL tree. Now we can see over this example. Take this example. This is the balance tree, because each and every node is having 0th location. Now, and the height is same. The height is same over here. That's why it is the balance tree. But look this example, in this second tree, C is having height 2. C is having height 2 as the left subtree. The left subtree is this, and the height of left subtree is 2. And if we consider the right subtree of C, there is no element. So the right subtree value is 0. Right? So the difference is that the difference is nothing but 2, because we will be finding out the difference by the considering the left subtree and right subtree. Now the left subtree is having the height 2 and right subtree is having 0, means your difference is 2. Now same way in this particular third number, here the right subtree is having value 2 and left subtree is having value 0, means it is not balanced, because your balance factor is 2, which should not be more than 1. So this is not the balance tree, and that's why AVL is responsible for balancing it, because the balance factor should be 1. So how the balance factor is calculated? So the height of left subtree minus height of right subtree. The height of left subtree, whatever left subtree we are having, the height of that minus height of right subtree is nothing but the balance factor, which is also known as VF is equal to HL minus HR, where VF is the balance factor, HL is height of left subtree and HR is height of right subtree. So the difference in the height of left hand subtree, if it is more than 1, then the tree is balanced by using the rotation techniques that we will see in detail in the next lecture. So these are the various features of the height balance tree. The height balance tree is having the left subtree and right subtree, and the height should not be more than 0, 1 and minus 1. Keep in mind, always the balance factor should not be more than 0, 1 and minus 1. It should be always in between these three. If we insert a node in the balance tree and if it becomes imbalanced, so we have to balance the tree. And for balancing the tree, the four type of rotations are used: LL, RR, LR and RL, which we will study in the next session. AVL tree is mainly called as height balance tree, in which the height is balanced of the tree. Every node in the AVL tree will have the balance factor minus 1, 0 or 1 only. It is compulsory that each and every node of the AVL tree should have the balance factor of minus 1, 0 or 1. And for making the tree balance, the various AVL rotations are used that we will see in our next session. Thank you.